Once you have these WAD versions copied and you transfer back the card, you can simply play them, provided you have Dolphin. So let's try Ocarina of Time. So I've done a couple of videos on Nintendo Wii Homebrew related stuff over the years. Homebrew in this case meaning unauthorized modding. First of all, I did one showing how to install the Homebrew channel. So basically you download this thing which you then chuck on your SD card, put that card into your console, go to your message board, and select this totally normal red letter icon, and it will then open this like CLI looking text screen where you can proceed through the options and it takes you back to the authorized menu again. And then should you choose to install it, a new Homebrew channel appears there, which if you open it, it allows you to run a variety of programs. I also put one such program on the SD card where it looks for, that lets you copy the contents of a game disc to a connected device, like the SD card you used, so that you can play it in something like Dolphin. Then I also have this video showing a number of other interesting things, like how to reassemble Wii game backups from this program by the terminal. Because the right format for the console will not support files over 4 gigs in size, which Wii games exceed, forcing you to split them into multiple files. So otherwise you can only use Dolphin to run any GameCube games you have. So if you don't even have a GameCube compatible console, using Dolphin isn't feasible. I mean, I do imagine Homebrew would still accept GameCube discs on that, but still. VLC. So I actually tried this, and it actually works. This is the intro demo for the game that shows up on a modeled screen. So since then, I've found out some other things as well. So here's an update on that. First off, I finally figured out how to put Wii Shop titles that you already purchased, like Virtual Console games, onto your SD card in a WAD format which Dolphin can run. You can already download or put them on the SD so that you can use that space for more games, but if you locate them on a computer, they're these Content.bin files, so they're in this binary format which Dolphin can't use. What you will need to do is to use Homebrew to convert it, which I believe is already part of how the console opens it normally, but then put that version on the SD, which it doesn't let you do. At least that's one way. So here's what you do. You download this thing called Yet Another Blue Dump Mod, open the zip file, then copy the folder into the apps folder on the root of your SD card, which Homebrew looks in to find applications. Put the SD in the console, start Homebrew, and you should see this program in the menu. If so, you open it, and once it launches, you can either use the remote or GameCube controller to control this, as you can do with the Homebrew menu, as well as many other apps. The controls for either of these devices are displayed next to each option here. Next step is to hit A to use full hardware access. This tells it to look for any external devices that you've inserted, like SDs. Anything you have downloaded from the Wii Shop will be under Installed Channel Titles, and then you can select Dump Options. Now these three options you can basically just skip with B. I have no idea what it does, but I don't think it makes any difference if you just want to mess with an emulator. If you do it this way though, I found it just gives you an error and says it failed to complete it. So the other way, which is the right way that works, is to select Content.bin Conversion, which you can do from any folder with anything selected, and it looks like it just shows the same stuff you can find in the installed titles folder. So then it says to hit A to convert your selected game into a WAD file. I just want the games. I don't care about stuff like Netflix, internet, Check Me Out, etc. That stuff is over a decade old, and it's obsolete and no longer supported, so don't waste your time on it. Then it shows the three options again. So go through them, and it should convert the game and copy that WAD file to the SD. This might take anywhere from a few seconds to like a minute or more, as I've found for stuff like Zelda the Ocarina of Time. Now a couple of other things I found is that 1, you can use this thing called WeeMFi to play discontinued online modes through an unofficial server, rather than Nintendo's server, which actually was discontinued back in 2014, which was surprisingly early to me, given the date when they stopped allowing you to buy games through the Wii Shop. So the way to use this is to launch it from Homebrew with your game disc inserted that of course has the online. Next, it will launch the game in a special way that tells it to use unauthorized servers if you try and open any online modes, enabling you to race several other players around the world today in Mario Kart, for example, like I remember doing back in the day. So that's kind of intriguing. There's also this thing called Devolution, which allows you to play GameCube ISO backups off an external device. and even use other controllers for them, not Wii backups, as again, they're too large for the SD format. Playing those off external storage is way more complicated. And interestingly, it actually needs you to put in the original disc at first, to verify that you have it. Although after that, the game will simply play because it's put a verification file on the SD, so it knows you probably have the authentic. If you try and launch the game first time without having the disc, the LED slot indicator will do this intermittent flashing pattern. It's a way of telling you to put the original disc in. Once you do this, it flashes 5 times in the first launch of that game, which you don't really see every day. You can also extract the DSP audio engine from the console, and apparently you can use it with Dolphin instead of using what it comes with. It can use 2 audio modes by default, HLE, which is basically faster, and LLE, which uses an unofficial DSP ROM, because I guess Nintendo doesn't want them showing the original one online, but you can use the one taken from your console for better audio. Anyways, once you have these WAD versions copied and you transfer back the card, these are located in this YABDM folder under WADs. So at this point, you can simply play them, provided you have Dolphin. So let's try Ocarina of Time. So that works. How about Too Fast for Gnomes? Well, it also works. It's a very simple 2D auto-scroller game that really transports me back to 2013, the good old days. Fascinating how media can do that. But anyway, this is a Wii game title, so I think it requires you to use the remote. Although you can remap the Wiimote controls here, so for instance, you can use a keyboard or a gamepad by remapping the controls of that to the controls of the remote, I will take this for a segue into the other thing I found, even though I just said that. You can use a Wii remote with your computer without having to use any special adapter cables or anything like that. You simply hit sync on the remote, which is underneath the battery cover. Then, you go to your Bluetooth settings and you see this new device, and you hit connect. Sync just tells us to become discoverable to in-range devices, because it's what you use when you first connect it, or if something goes wrong, or if you sync it with another device. In any case, you then have to hit sync on the console as well. I literally wasn't aware of this. I just looked up because I was curious about that, how to use the Wii remote with your computer. And as it turns out, that is how. Unfortunately, the IR function is still not going to work, because you can't use a sensor bar without using some special adapter, so some Wii games will not be playable, at least not past a certain point. On the other hand, the GameCube controller, because it doesn't use Bluetooth, flat out cannot be used without buying a special USB adapter, for example. So as you might think, well, wouldn't there be some way to use the mouse? Well, unfortunately, Dolphin can't do this properly. There is this mouse option in the controller configs, but it turns out this is mouse velocity, how much it moves on any given frame, and it uses that as the offset from the center, instead of using where the mouse position actually is, so you get this very janky effect where it's sort of attracted to the center of the screen, making it very annoying and difficult to select options depending on where they are. Not really ideal. You can like type in cursor if people have suggested this, but I haven't really found this to work. It seems like maybe it's sort of evolved over Dolphin's development or something. On top of this, it also has trouble with games that require the use of a nunchuck, like Mario Galaxy. There's a setting for what type of controls to use, which you have 3 options. Emulated, which allows you to use your remap configurations, real, which is just using the remote, and hybrid, which uses both. However, the nunchuck for some reason only works if you use the real setting, meaning you can't even use the mouse while using the remote, rendering some pointer functions, like absorbing starbursts with the cursor, practically unplayable. If you have to use the mouse, the game will pause if it can't find a nunchuck. So you can't even use hybrid, you have to use emulated mode and have the mouse selected as the config input so you can only use the mouse, and select nunchuck as the extension. And going back to the cursor issue, I could only get to some options by swiftly moving the mouse in that direction and hit F to frame advance, trying to get the timing right so that it will advance in the middle of the mouse movement. And then once I can barely reach the option and I can see it respond to the pointer, hold down the left mouse, which I map to A on the remote, while advancing, and it just might click it. If you want to back up these games, or especially if you want to get rid of your console, it does seem to me that stuff like this is something that you should be aware of. To avoid ending on a down note, the accelerometer does still work, so you can still shake the remote to spin Mario, that being a defining feature of this game. On a similar branch, let's try DKC Returns. This game is basically a side platformer and a sequel to the Super Nintendo DKC games. You use the D-pad to move. You pound the remote up and down while stationary to break stuff, and while moving to roll. And these functions still work in Dolphin. And the game allows you to only use the remote, so it actually theoretically is totally playable. Well, in any case, I hope you found this interesting, and if so, the algorithm really deserves to know. As always, thanks for watching.